Welcome to lecture 10 on module 5 for the subject ARM microcontroller and embedded systems. So subject code is 15EC or 17EC62. In the previous lecture we discussed about task communication. So what is task communication, when it is needed, what are the various types of task communication. So task communication is necessary for conveying some data from one process to another process. So we saw that two processes or tasks may need to communicate with each other because they require the input from one another to complete their operation. Okay, so to pass this data, so we talked about task communication and various techniques used in task communication. So next is task synchronization. So task synchronization is very useful whenever resources are shared among various tasks or processes. For example, let's say in a cyber cafe there is a single printer which is being shared between let's say 5 or 6 computers, and suppose the users on these computers want to print something. So they give the print command simultaneously, but all the 5 users, whatever the data they have given to print, it cannot be printed simultaneously because there is a single printer which is shared among these 5 systems or the users. So then what will happen is the printing will be done one after the other. Okay, so from first system, let's say the data is received, then it will be printed. Then let's say from system 5 the data is received, it will be printed. So like this, single printer is being shared here. So this is when synchronization is required. Why? Because so whenever the shared resource is being utilized by one process or task, the other process has to wait for it, and whenever the printer or the resource becomes free, the task which was using it earlier has to communicate to the other process saying that now the resource is free, you can make use of it, I have done my operation and I have completed. So this convey of or some synchronization signals are to be are very useful whenever resources are being shared. So what is synchronization? So multiple processes may try to access and modify shared resources in a multitasking environment. So this may lead to conflicts and inconsistent results. Why? Because they are trying to access a single resource and more than one process is trying to access that resource simultaneously. So there should be some way of synchronization between them, so that whenever one is using the resource, the other should not go and use the same resource or try to use the same resource. It has to wait until that resource becomes free. So processes should be made aware of access of shared resource by each process and should not be allowed to access a shared resource when it is currently being accessed by another process. So this is very important. Suppose you are accessing a piece of memory, let's say a location in the memory. So that location contains some data which will be read as well as written. So you can read the data from that location and as well as write the data to that location. In that case, whenever one process is utilizing or is making use of the contents of that memory location, some other process should not be given access to the same memory location. Okay, why? Because as I told, it is not only read, it is write also. So if it is only read operation that is being done on that memory location, then it is fine because you cannot modify the data. But since modify is also allowed, so the process until the process which is utilizing that location completes its operation, because once the process completes the operation, then only the updated value will be available in that location. So until that updated value is available on that location, the other process should not be allowed to access that same location because the contents may be changed after the completion of the process. So I'll give an example. So let's say this is the memory location. So since it is a memory location, it will have some address. So 0x, let's say the location is 4000. This is the location. And let's say the data here is 5. Okay. So there are, let's say, two processes which make use of this shared resource. So let's say this is P2 and this is P1. So both utilize the same memory location or the content in the memory location. Let's say P1 is currently utilizing or accessing this location. Okay, so please remember P1 can do both read as well as write operation on the memory location. So let's say it has accessed the memory location. Since it has accessed this location, it is accessing the data in the location, which is 5. So it will take the data 5 and it does some operation. Okay, so it is doing some, let's say, arithmetic operation on this 5, the data 5. And what is its job is, after the operation, arithmetic operation is done on the data, it will update the final value to the same location. So let's say the arithmetic location is multiply, so it is multiply by 4. So this data multiplied by 4, so it is 20. So 5 into 4 is 20. So finally that 20 will be stored back to the same location. So that 20 will be stored to this location. Okay, only after P1 completes its arithmetic operation on 5, and then it will update. So until then, the new value is not available here. Okay, so in the meanwhile, suppose P2 is also given the access to the same location. So then what will happen is, so P2, instead of using the updated value, which is 20, it will use the same value, which will be 5. Why? Because P2 is given the access to the shared resource in the same time when P1 is also given the access to the shared resource. So this should not happen. Why? Because P2, whenever it accesses this location, it should always get the updated value, which will be written here, that is, which will be 20, only after P1 completes the operation. So that means P2 should not be given access to this shared memory location until P1 holds or P1 is utilizing this location. So this is what is synchronization. So until P1 completes the usage of this shared location, P2 should not be given the access to this shared location, because P2 may get a wrong data or a old data, which is 5. But actually P2 should get 20, which is the updated value, and this will be done only after P1 completes. So as soon as P1 completes, there will be some sort of mechanism which will intimate that P1, which was utilizing this location, has completed its operation. So P2 will be intimated that P2 can use the location. So then P2 will get the new value or updated value, which is 20. So this is what will happen. So that is what is discussed here. So should not be allowed to access a shared resource when it is currently being accessed by another process. Okay. So the act of making processes aware of the access of shared resource by each process to avoid conflicts is known as task synchronization. So this is what is task synchronization. So you should have some way of intimating a process that not to access a shared resource because that shared resource is currently being accessed by some other resource. So once this resource utilization is completed by that process, then only this next process will be given the access to the shared resource. So this sort of arrangement or some sort of signaling is known as process synchronize. This is very essential for avoiding conflicts in shared resource access. So I told this, right? So P2 should always get the updated value of this location, and this updated value will be there, will be present in this location only after P1 completes the access of this location and writes back the updated value. Then only P2 should be given the access. Okay, so this is what to avoid conflicts. So first type of synchronization issue is racing. So what happens if there is no task synchronization? So this is the first issue that will arise if there is no task synchronization, which is known as racing. So what is this racing? I'll give an example. So see this diagram here. So let's say there are two trains, train 1 and train 2, that want to complete their journeys. Okay, so let's say the journey is from, so let's say train 1, the journey is from Bangalore to Tumkur, and train 2, the journey is from Tumkur to Bangalore. So both have to complete their journeys, but there is a single track, there is a shared track. Okay, so both the trains cannot run on the same track. So what will happen if both the trains run on the same track simultaneously? Accident will happen. Getting what I'm saying? So this is what is racing. So in racing, what will happen is, see, let's say this single track is there, and train 1 is given the access to this track by the station master. Let's say the station master has given the access of the shared track to train 1. Okay? So train 1 is currently running on the track. So that is, it is running from Bangalore to Tumkur. So at the same time, the station master has to intimate train 2, has to intimate train 2 that this track, which is a single track, which is a shared track, is currently given to train 1, and so that you should not use train 2. Sorry, you should not use the same track. So if the station master intimates train 2 about the track usage, that it is already in use, so train 2 will wait until train 1 can complete its journey on this shared track. But if the station master doesn't intimate train 2 that the track is already being used by train 1, then what will happen is train 2 will also try to make use of the same track to complete its journey from Tumkur to Bangalore. So in that scenario, both the trains are on the same track in opposite directions. So they will meet up somewhere and accident will happen. So this should not happen. So this is what is the typical racing condition. Okay. So one more example is, so this is one more example wherein there is a display. So this is a display. Let's say it is a 16 cross 2 LCD display. So this display will have a buffer, display buffer. So what is the buffer means? It is the memory wherein you write the whatever you want to display using this LCD display. So whatever the data you will write in this buffer, that will be displayed on the screen. So that is what is display buffer. Okay. So now let's say process 1 is trying to display something. Okay. So using this display, so this display is a shared resource. So there is only one display and there are multiple processes which are waiting to utilize the display to display something, some message. So let's say process 1 is given the access to utilize this display and it wants to display the message shop is open. Okay. So what it will do is it will write this data shop is open into the display buffer, and as soon as it writes the message onto this buffer, so the same thing will be start to display here on the display. So let's say the message is shop is open and it is written onto the buffer, so it starts displaying. So it will start to display shop and it will next start to display ease. So as soon as it displays ease, so let's say process 2 also accesses the same shared resource. Okay, so it also accesses the same shared resource and it wants to display closed. Okay, so it will write the closed data to this buffer. Then what will happen? So this process one, which wants to display shop is open, it has not yet been completed. The message is not completely displayed. So the message that was displayed was shop is. Till this it was displayed. So at that time, process two writes closed, the message closed to this display. So then what will happen is a wrong message will be displayed. What is the wrong message? Previously shop is was displayed, and instead of open, that is, the message that will be displayed is closed. So this will happen. Why? Because process 1 is also utilizing the same shared resource, and process 2 also tries and accesses the same resource, which is currently being accessed by process 1. So this should not happen. So the shared resource should be given access one at a time. Okay, so no two processes can make use of the same shared resource simultaneously. Okay, so this is what will happen in racing. So if there is no synchronization between process 1 and process 2, saying that, so process 1 is utilizing the display, let me wait, that is process 2, let me wait until process 1 completes the usage. So if this synchronization is not there between process 1 and process 2, so this racing will take place. This is the first type of synchronization issue. So what will happen in race condition? The situation in which multiple processes compete or race each other to access and manipulate shared data concurrently. So there is some shared data. So multiple processes compete with each other to access and manipulate it. Manipulate means update the value. So in race condition, the final value of the shared data depends on the process which acted on the data finally. We shall see this using an example. So what will happen in race condition? Yeah, so whatever the example here, I've taken it here so that they are side by side and you can easily compare between them. So let's say there are two processes. So one is process A and one more is process B. So what does process A do? So what it will do is, see, it has some for loop. So for i is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So until this condition is true. So if buffer of I is greater than 0, so what is buffer? So it is a shared resource or a shared memory. So buffer, remember, is a shared memory. So the content in this buffer, is if this content in this buffer is greater than 0, so then counter will be incremented. So remember, buffer is some shared resource which is being used for comparing with the value of 0, and you are, based on that, you are updating a counter. So counter plus plus. So this is also a shared resource. So counter plus plus. So why it is shared? Because here process B also does the same job. So it will take some j. Again, it will check if the content of buffer is greater than 0. Again, it will update counter. So, in both, the common thing that is being updated is counter. Okay, so counter plus plus as well as counter plus. So, both these processes are utilizing a shared memory location, which is counter. Okay, counter plus plus, counter plus. And process A and process B, they exist in the memory simultaneously. So there should be some mechanism to synchronize between these two, saying that when process A is incrementing the counter, process B should not increment the counter. Why? Because this will lead to conflicts. Both should not increment the same shared resource or shared memory at the same time, because it will lead to wrong results. Okay, so there should be some synchronization between these two. But if there is no synchronization between these two, or there is no synchronization mechanism between these two, what will happen? We shall see. So this counter plus plus, it is in high level language, it will look like a single statement. But whenever it is implemented in machine level or in a lower level language, this is what it will look like. So this counter plus plus, one statement is actually split into three statements. So So first what you will do is you will access, so the first statement is accessing the shared location, accessing in a sense, so you have to access the previous value. Okay, why? Because here, let's say the previous value of counter is 4, right? Previous value of counter is 4, so you have to access that value 4. Fine. First you have to access that value 4, then you have to increment it to plus 1, so then the new value will be 5. So this 5 again you have to update to the counter variable. So it is counter plus plus is nothing but it is counter equal to counter plus 1. So this is what will happen. Okay. So you have to get the previous value, which is 4, add 1 to it. So the result is 5. So that result you have to store back to the same variable. So this should what will happen whenever it is counter plus plus. Okay, so it is not easy. So it is not a single step execution. So this is what will happen here. So first, you fetch the previous value. Okay, and you will store it to some register here. So EAX 4. So then you add 1 to this 4. So 5. The result is 5. And you then store back that result to, store back that result to the previous location. So store back the 2 to the same location. So it is, as I told, fetch the previous value, add 1 to it, then store the result to the same location. So this is what will happen. Okay. So this counter plus plus has 3 statements whenever it is written in low level language or converted to lower level language. So this is assembly. So process B also has the same set of instructions, and process A also has the same set of instructions. Why? Because both are incrementing counter plus plus and counter plus. So remember, process B has separate memory and process A will also have separate memory. So process B will have its own EAX register and process A will have its own EAX register. So they are not same. Then what is the problem that will arise if there is no synchronization? So then what will happen is, so let's say process A accesses the shared memory, which is counter. Okay, so it will get the previous value, because first you have to get the previous value before you increment. So let's say you get the previous value, which is 4. Okay, so you move the, or you access the location which is pointed by this pointer to that shared location, and you will fetch the value in that location, which is 4. Okay, so once you get 4, next step is to add 1 to it, that is increment, right? Before process A can increment that value, let's say a context switch will happen. So context switch means process A is preempted due to some reason, and process B will get its chance to execute. Getting this? Process A is preempted due to some reason, and process B is the next one who will get the chance to execute. So process B, what it will do, it will also wants to increment the counter, same. So again it will fetch the same value, okay, from the pointer. It will point to the memory location. So in that location the content is 4. So it will fetch 4. So it will update it. So 4 plus 1 becomes 5. Okay, and once 5, so this 5 will be written back to the same memory location, which is the previous counter value. So 4 has been incremented to 5. So after this operation completes, let's say again context switch will take place. Process B is preempted. Process A gets its chance. So it will continue from wherever it had left. Okay, so where it had left, it had fetched the value, which was 4, from the shared resource. So now it will update this. So 4 plus 1 will become 5. And it will store back that to the shared location, which is 5. So this result that you got at the end of this is wrong, actually. Why it is wrong? Because, see, since both are updating the same value, so if this process B has incremented it from 4 to 5, okay, so then process A has to get 5 and it has to increment 5 to 6, not 5. From 5 to 5 it should not become, it should access 5, which is the updated value, and it will update or it will add 1 to it and increment it. It should become 6, but you can see the result here. It is not 6, it is 5. So this will happen only when you allow the shared resource to be accessed by multiple processes. So how to avoid this? Very simple. So let's say process A has accessed the shared resource. So as soon as it accesses the shared resource, there should be some tag or a flag saying that, so this flag will be set to 1. Okay, so this flag will be set to 1. Why? Because process A has accessed a shared resource. So set this flag to 1. So if this resource is currently being accessed, so flag will be 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. So since it is currently accessed by process A, this flag will be set to 1. Okay, so then what will happen? So it will fetch the value in this location, which is 4. So now, due to some reason, before it increments, a context which will happen because process A is preempted. So process B will get its chance. And whenever process B again tries to access the same location, same memory location, same memory, same shared resource, it should not be allowed to access the same shared resource. Why? Because it has to check this flag. Okay, so process B has to check this flag. If this flag is 1, that means the shared resource is already being used by some other resource. In this case, it is process A. So process B should not be given access to the shared memory location because this flag is set to 1. So as soon as process B comes to know that F is equal to 1, that means it will come to know that so some process is already using the shared resource. So process B, what it will do is it will wait. It will not continue. It will not continue to access the shared location, add 1 to it and update it. It will not happen. It will just wait. So until when it will wait? Until this flag 1 becomes 0. So when this flag 1 equal to 1 becomes 0, whenever process A again gets its chance, it will update the value of the value here. So 4 plus 1, 5. And then it will store back that 5 to the shared resource. So once this step completes, this will go back and change the flag value to 0. So as soon as this flag value becomes 0, process B, which is regularly monitoring this flag value, will come to know that the flag value has become 0. That means it need not wait now. This resource, the shared resource is available. It can continue its job. Okay. This is the basic of whatever the task synchronization issue that is raising. So same example is discussed here, but it is not side by side. It is written one after the other. This as we write the program, normal program. So same thing is written here. So go through that. So whatever I discuss, same thing is available here. And the same explanation is given here. So you can see the statement. Okay, so same statement I have taken there also, same examples I have given there, same whatever the explanation I gave till now, same thing is available in this explanation. Go through it, understand it, and go through the video also to understand the explanation, same example. Okay, so we shall talk about the next synchronization issue. So what if there is no task synchronization? What are the other issues that may arise? The other issue that may arise is deadlock. It is a very popular task synchronization issue. So this we will discuss in the next lecture. Thank you.